Chinese manufactured drones are a real and present threat to the security of this country.
DJI is based in China and has known ties with the Chinese Communist Party, which represents a national security risk to the United States.
Something that almost never happens just happened. As of today, DJI's brand new Mavic 4 Pro is not selling in the US. Tariffs and just barely dodging a permanent ban in the US, DJI has just 1 year to make their case before their fate is determined. In fact, as of this video, it's starting to look like a lot of their products are sold out in the US. But how did a Chinese drone manufacturer become so dominant that it controls anywhere from 80 to 90% of the consumer drone market? And why has no American company been able to make a viable competitor? Today, we're looking at DJI's dominance, failed attempts by US companies to challenge it, and why DJI's US operations are shakier than ever. But at the end of this video, I'll tell you why I think they are not going anywhere. Just how dominant is DJI? Let's focus on two numbers. Number one, market share. Consensus is that DJI is behind 70% of the world's drones, which actually seems like a really conservative number, and 90% of the US consumer drone market. Sure, that number sounds a lot like Apple's iPhone dominance in the US market. But consider this, where's the Samsung, where's the Android of consumer drone products? It doesn't feel like there's any. This isn't just about consumer drones either. DJI has established themselves for enterprise and commercial applications as well, from construction and real estate to agriculture and cinematography. And while they are fighting against military labeling, they've found themselves inevitably on the battlefields. Number two, the dollar signs. DJI is a multi-billion dollar company, suspected to be earning anywhere from $3 billion to $5 billion per year, and valued at over $15 billion. Everything points to a fleet of over 2 million drones out there today. So what were DJI's first products if they weren't actually drones? DJI, or Dajiang Innovations, began in a college dorm room in 2006, when founder Frank Wang was still a student in China. Wang started building and selling flight controls and other core components. They stabilize them mid-air, they add autopilot, and they enable teleoperations. By 2009, the company had created their first unmanned aerial vehicle, that's UAV. They were actively testing their hardware products on a bunch of different remote control UAVs, including rotary, helicopters. Drones were the natural evolution of the remote control ages, and DJI broke them out of the hobbyist category in 2013 when they released Phantom. The Phantom series was introduced and quickly found success, especially at a time where YouTube was exploding, GoPro was enabling epic moments, and the iPhone 5S was able to record 1080p HD video. In 2014, DJI released the Inspire 1, their commercial production drone. In 2015, both the Agris agricultural drone and the Mavic, their prosumer drone. Matrix, their enterprise drone in 2016, the Air, which was small but high quality in 2018, and their pocket-sized super affordable mini in 2019, a product that basically anyone could get their hands on. Flycart, their super heavy drone, was released in 2023. DJI's story is almost entirely documented on their YouTube channel. Hundreds and hundreds of videos dating back 15 plus years. You can see every single component, all of the tests, all of the experiments, every single iteration, testing across UAVs that weren't their own. And it's no wonder, controlling so many of the key components inside the drones, that they found success when they ultimately brought one to market, and that probably enabled them to bring drone after drone in this really rapid sequence. And this leads directly into their business success. DJI is a story of relentless pursuit in R&D, in engineering, but also in quality, and probably a really key component, a perfect supply chain. But DJI is also a story of business strategy and execution. Let's talk about the main points. One, first mover advantage and continuous innovation. DJI was early to the market with consumer-friendly drones that were easy to use, yet produced really high quality results. The Phantom series made aerial photography accessible to anyone. It was a product that any enthusiast could buy, whether they liked cool tech or were actually passionate about photo and video. DJI went on to release product after product, and perhaps above all, continuously innovating on the form factor without compromising quality. You can actually fit a DJI Mini in your pocket. It weighs less than 249 grams. DJI has also really extended the breadth of their products. They include action cameras and professional quality film equipment like gimbals, as well as gigantic portable batteries because you need a lot of power for all of this equipment, and drone docks. Two, vertical integration and manufacturing efficiency. DJI designs and manufactures nearly every component of its drones in-house, from the motors and the electronic speed controllers to the gimbals and the cameras. In fact, they're a majority shareholder of the famous and super expensive Hasselblad Swedish camera company. Vertical integration allows for tighter quality control, faster iteration, and most importantly, significantly lower production costs. Located in Shenzhen, China's manufacturing hub, DJI can rapidly prototype, test, and mass produce new designs with remarkable efficiency. Shenzhen is basically alluded to as the global electronic supply chain, where any part or component, whether generic or custom spec, can be ordered. 3. Pricing strategy and market segmentation. DJI has masterfully segmented the drone market, offering products at various price points from the entry-level mini series to the professional Inspire and Matrix lines. This strategy allows them to capture customers at every level while creating a natural upgrade path. Think about it, if you have a mini but you really want to push the limits, hey, you have the option for an Air or the Mavic. And this now, bit by bit, is extendable into their camera lines. Their pricing is also really aggressive. That's great for consumers, but that makes it really difficult to compete directly with DJI. 4. Software and ecosystem development. DJI has built an extensive software ecosystem, super simple flight controls, and easy-to-use video editing apps. Their hardware products reliably connect to their software for real-time visualization, and to keep things simple for users, they have built-in flight moves so that even a novice can record super great footage and facilitate an industrial inspection or go through and spray their crops with the industrial agriculture products. 5. Broad appeal across user segments. Starting with mass producing for the consumers and leveling into professional-grade cinema products, DJI is now well into major industrial and agricultural applications. Their DJI drones capable of carrying 30 kilograms over 15 kilometers. DJI drones can replace crop planes for crop spraying, and drones are increasingly a part of law enforcement and military strategy. Let's talk failed competitors. Now, in DJI's route to dominance, it's not like they were completely uncontended. In fact, some huge brand names went after their market. So, why hasn't any American company been able to successfully compete with DJI? It's certainly not for the lack of effort. In 2016, GoPro, riding the heights of their famous action cameras, entered the drone market with Karma. This seemed like a natural extension for the company, and there was a ton of excitement around the launch. Just weeks after launch, Karma had to be recalled. Drones were literally losing power mid-flight and falling from the sky. Even after relaunching in 2017, the Karma couldn't compete with DJI's Mavic. It was lighter, smaller, cheaper, and had features that Karma lacked, like obstacle avoidance and autonomous follow models. By January 2018, GoPro cut the project completely and unfortunately had to lay off the staff. There's Skydio too. Skydio actually produced a super impressive consumer drone, and in fact, in many ways, especially in terms of autonomy, it could outcompete some of DJI's offerings. Skydio was founded in 2014, and they really leaned into autonomous and AI-powered tracking. Despite technological advantages and raising hundreds of millions of dollars in funding, Skydio announced that in 2023, it was abandoning the consumer market. It was going to entirely focus on enterprise and government customers. Competing with DJI's scale, pricing, and product range proved unsustainable. And well, given DJI's limitations to do a lot with enterprise and with government customers, it was just a pretty obvious market. Skydio's CEO explained when shutting down their consumer business, "The impact we're having with our enterprise and public sector customers has become so compelling that it demands nothing less than our full focus and attention." 3D Robotics, 3DR, was another promising American drone startup that tried to challenge DJI. The company raised over $100 million in venture capital to compete for the consumer drone market. Their solo drone, released in 2015, was marketed as the Smart Drone, but production problems, software issues, and intense price competition from DJI led to disappointing sales. By 2016, 3DR had laid off most of its staff and pivoted entirely to drone software rather than hardware. These failures tell a consistent story. Even well-funded American companies with pretty impressive technical expertise just couldn't compete with DJI's manufacturing expertise, costs, and basically how they entered and competed in markets. It ultimately was about scale and pricing power, all of which DJI had massive advantages in. But American drone manufacturers do have one shining light. They have the entire federal government to sell into. And with that, we have tons of new American drone companies coming to market, specifically serving enterprise and federal. We're seeing them build products for defense, we're seeing them build products for forests, for wildfires, all sorts of search and rescue, and basically trying to go exactly where DJI can't.
With this action, Congress will ensure that future versions of DJI drones cannot be imported, marketed, or sold in the United States.
DJI is now facing its greatest challenge yet, and it seems that it has a deadline of less than 1 year. That is increasing scrutiny from the US government over national security concerns. One argument is that DJI could be compelled to share data with its government. That could include sensitive information about infrastructure, government facilities, or other critical sites captured by the drones. DJI has responded aggressively to these concerns with definitive product actions. They've implemented a local data mode that prevents internet connections, they've created a government edition drone with additional security features, and they're commissioning independent security audits. The result of that? For the first time ever, the DJI Mavic 4 Pro, a brand new released product, is just not selling in the US. It's not available. That's their newest, flagship, consumer drone, costing over $2,500. Just not available to the largest market in the world. The company stated that it would love to bring the Mavic 4 Pro to the US, but it currently has no timeline for when it can be introduced to the US market. Ongoing geopolitical tensions, shifting economic relations in the form of tariffs, and an outright ban threat give good reason to pause new products and especially new models going into the US. Often is the case, the prior generation Mavic 3 Pro still rocks. But the new drone does have at least one or two really notable feats. 100 megapixel Hasselblad camera. As I said earlier, DJI is actually a majority shareholder of Hasselblad, the fancy Swedish camera maker. I'm talking super expensive cameras. Just look them up, it'll blow your mind. A 360 degree rotating gimbal, which looks like it's gonna create a whole new shot selection. One that just, even with video editing software, wasn't there before. And of course, better AI obstacle avoidance and some flight time, sure. Prediction time. So what do I think is actually gonna happen with this whole threat of banning DJI, especially on the consumer side? Well, as a drone enthusiast and someone studying these types of hardware companies, especially those that are looking into enterprise and perhaps government use, it's a tricky one, and I think it looks a lot like TikTok. When TikTok became the US's most downloaded app in quarter four of 2019, the Committee on Foreign Investment in the United States, CFIUS for short, launched an investigation. The intention was a 90-day deadline. Whoa, what year is it now? Because that deadline is still going on.
Last night, the Senate took the important step of unanimously on a bipartisan basis passing legislation to ban TikTok on all government devices.
After multiple attempts, TikTok was finally banned, but only on government devices. Nearly 6 years since that investigation, yes, some threats, yes, some speculation, yes, some push and pull on the political spectrum, and the whole time, just a whole lot of monetization on TikTok. If anything, flash forward to today, TikTok looks a lot like a negotiating chip in a larger conversation about trade and the relations between the US and China. DJI and TikTok are obviously wildly different products. TikTok, on the hand, is this massive social application. We're talking in the hundreds of millions of users. DJI, on the other hand, builds physical products. But DJI is still here. And in fact, they have a history dating just as long. In 2018, the Department of Defense issued a ban on the purchase and use of all commercial off-the-shelf drones, regardless of manufacturers, due to cybersecurity concerns. The following year, Congress passed legislation specifically banning the purchase and use of drones and components manufactured in China. DJI has long been on the Department of Commerce's list of entities determined to be acting contrary to the national security or foreign policy interests of the United States. While activity over the past 1 year has definitely picked up, and DJI officially has less than 1 year before its fate is to be determined, at least on paper, again, DJI is still here, and the government moves very slow on these things. And let's not forget, these drones have massive implications for agencies that are preventing wildfires, that may be looking at climate change, and perhaps are just doing search and rescue. Wrapping everything up, DJI is a story of relentless pursuit. As we spoke about, there's this clear timeline. You can see video after video, all of these tests, all of these experiments that are happening many years before Phantom is released. And then finally, once Phantom is released, year after year preceding that, all of these new products come to market. Testing, developing, sharing, improving. It's really the story of iteration and moving quickly. This is also a story of manufacturing capabilities, economies of scale, and access to a really robust domestic and local electronic supply chain. And above all, it's a story of achieving dominance while having these security concerns lingering over your product, not just since 2025, but since 2018 and likely even before that, being subject to government forces and other factors completely outside of your control. So, what do you think is going to happen with the DJI ban? In writing, they have less than 1 year before their fate's determined. Regardless, let me know what you think, and thank you again for taking the time to watch all these. I appreciate it, and we'll see you in the next video.